Good morning, dear children. I hope now democracy and the role of parliament is clear to you from our first session. We will recall what we have done in the previous session and then continue with today's part. We learned democracy is rule of the people, by the people and for the people. The distribution of power and responsibility makes the representatives of the government accountable to the citizens of the country. We also learned about monarchy, that is rule of the king. The formation of parliament constitutes of president, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Now let's continue with today's session. The election for the Lok Sabha and the state legislative assembly, that is the Vidhan Sabha, are conducted in the same way. Lok Sabha elections are held every 5 years. Each constituency is represented by one elected member in the parliament. The candidates who contest for the seat in parliament are usually active in various political parties. The elected candidate is known as the member of parliament or MP. All these elected members collectively form the Lok Sabha. So Lok Sabha is the lower house of the or the house of the people. It is people's representative body where the members are directly elected by the people. A total of 552 members are there in the Lok Sabha. 530 members are from the states, 20 members from union territories, and 2 members are nominated by the president from the Anglo-Indian community. The country is divided into constituencies based on the population and members from each constituency. The term of Lok Sabha is 5 years. It can be dissolved by the president in case of emergency. How is the ruling party formed? After the elections of Lok Sabha, party-wise list of all the members of the parliament is formed. From this list, it becomes clear how many members from which political parties are there. If any party wants to form the government, then there should be a majority of elected members from that party. After the elections, the leader of the party or a coalition of the parties which has a clear majority in the parliament is appointed as the Prime Minister in the Lok Sabha. The Prime Minister of India is the head of the ruling party. So once the elections for the Lok Sabha are over, the winning representatives are listed down. All these representatives are part of one or the other party, or they might be individual representatives. The candidate who gets the maximum number of votes and the party that has majority in the parliament forms the government. The candidate with majority votes becomes the head of the ruling party and is appointed as the Prime Minister. The Prime Minister selects ministers from the members of his party. In this way, the Council of Ministers is formed. The ministers with Prime Minister take all the decisions. These ministers take care of the responsibilities of the work related to their respective ministries, such as health, education, finance, etc. Each minister is responsible for any question related to his ministry to the members of parliament. So the Prime Minister is given the responsibility of selecting his team. So he forms a council of ministers. These ministers act as the helping hand to the Prime Minister. They advise him in taking decisions, responsibly work to implement the decisions taken, and then are equally responsible or answerable for any questions in the parliament. Now let's look into how is Rajya Sabha or the upper house formed. The elected members of the legislative assembly of each state elect members for Rajya Sabha. There are 250 members in the Rajya Sabha. Out of them, 238 are elected. The remaining 12 members are nominated by the President of India. The Rajya Sabha is the permanent house. It never gets dissolved completely. 1/3 of the members of Rajya Sabha retire every 2 years after completing their 6 years term, and the new members are included. Rajya Sabha, it is a permanent body and is the Council of States. Total members 238 members from the states and union territories, and 12 members who are nominated by the president. 12 members who are nominated by the president are usually scholars from various fields like literature, science, commerce, social services, arts, etc. Members who are elected for 6 years, however, 1/3 members retire in every 2 years. They are elected by the members of Legislative Assembly of each state. The Rajya Sabha represents the states of our country. The Rajya Sabha also can propose a bill. It is important to have the consent of the Rajya Sabha before passing any bill. This House of Parliament reviews the bill passed by the Lok Sabha. Thus, the role of Rajya Sabha is very important. The person who presides over the sessions of Rajya Sabha is known as the chairman. The Vice President of India acts as the chairman of the Rajya Sabha. So, various states are represented by the Rajya Sabha. A bill can also be proposed by Rajya Sabha just like Lok Sabha. Any bill that is proposed in the Lok Sabha comes to the Rajya Sabha for consent and reviewing. It is only when the bill gets the consent of the Rajya Sabha that it goes to the president. The Rajya Sabha can also suggest amendments in the bill, that is changes in the bills. The Vice President acts as the chairman of the Rajya Sabha and presides over all its sessions. Question R. The first is the first hour of a sitting session of India's Lok Sabha devoted to questions that members of parliament raise about any aspect of administrative activity. The concerned minister is obliged to answer to the parliament either orally or in writing depending on the type of question raised. So, the first hour of every sitting of the Lok Sabha is usually the question hour, during which the members ask questions and the concerned ministers answers those questions. Let's look into question hour session in the parliament. When the parliament is in session at the beginning of the day, the time for the question hour is decided upon. During the question hour, the members of parliament ask questions to gather information on the working of the government. This is how the parliament controls the executive. Through the medium of questioning, members draw the attention of the government towards its loopholes. In this way, the government comes to know about the views and opinions of the people through their representatives. It is an important responsibility of the members to question the government. The opposition party plays a major role in the effective administration of a democracy. It highlights the loopholes in the policies and the programs of the government. The person who presides over the sessions in the Lok Sabha is known as the speaker. So, it is usually taken up between 11 a.m. and 12 p.m. of every day of sitting. It is an important parliamentary session available to the members to seek information from the government on an issue of public importance. When a bill needs to be implemented, the role of the opposition party becomes very important. They can challenge, debate, and even suggest on the working of any policy put up by the Lok Sabha. They can help find the advantages and disadvantages of a bill that needs to be passed and so help the government identify the loopholes in any policy or bill to be passed. So, the opposition party helps in the effective administration of the government. The speaker presides over the sessions in the Lok Sabha. President is the most important and integral part of the parliament. A bill that is passed by both the houses can become a law only after his signature. He has the power to decide about the meetings of the parliament and announces the completion of sessions too. So, after a thorough examination of any bill or policy to be implemented, it goes from the Lok Sabha to the Rajya Sabha. As soon as the bill gets the consent from the Rajya Sabha, it goes to the president for approval. The president goes through the bill and only when he signs does the bill become a law. So, the role of the president is very important. He has many powers vested in him. He can decide upon the meetings of a parliament. He can even decide upon the completion. There are so many powers that have been given to the president in the constitution. Executive powers are there, legislative powers are there, diplomatic, military, and judicial powers have been given to him. So, children. With this, we come to the end of this session as well as the chapter. Thoroughly go through both the videos and try to understand the role of Parliament. Read the chapter from the book. Write the PDF content in your notebook. Stay home. Stay safe. Thank you.